What's up, guys? Jordan Hutchinson here. I'm here with Chris Tuttle at Absolute Recon. We're about to get some back and buys in. Just missing my intro workout. We got 45 grams of carbs from C block. Doing a scoop of lockdown intro. I already did a scoop prior. And then we're gonna do a scoop of confined. This is a new peach mango flavor. It's actually my favorite combo that I've tried, is the peach mango with the lemon lime lockdown. So I just tried that the other day and it's been my new favorite. So we're gonna mix this up. Then we're gonna start going on some back and buys.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna isolate lats first.
Okay.
And then upper back. And then Terry's minor major.
Okay.
All right.
That's good.
So we'll.
That's good.
Well, we just gotta find the best movement for you now.
Right. So. This will be similar to what I usually do.
Okay.
But the same kind of angle. Usually I'm doing a cable, that's a high cable.
Yeah.
That's my first movement anyways. Feel it right there in that lower lat.
Sure.
So nice.
So this is the fucked up part. So keep your shoulder blade completely stationary. Extend your arm carefully.
Right there.
Now squeeze down. Don't move the shoulder blade. Slow, slow, slow. Hold the shoulder down and back as you extend your arm. Yes. Correct. Yep. Get this further down. Yep. The less your scapula, the more your lat tension will occur. It's hard to do this.
Without naturally, your shoulder wants to come forward.
Correct.
That's honestly what a lot of people do with any of their pull downs and stuff. They just roll way forward. They're coming off of their lats.
Yeah.
As soon as you come off, and I mean, I'm even thinking I'm doing it and you're correcting a little bit, but like, everybody comes off of their lats as soon as they let that shoulder roll forward. And a lot of people have majorly undeveloped lats.
And the thing is this, right? It's like, if lats are your weak point, that means you have a lot of teres minor major taking up for the movement, right? So now you have to move in a way to make sure there's more tension on their dormant lat that's not firing like it's supposed to. Some people can do everything wrong and their lats grow because that's how they're built. But when we're trying to bring more tension to one area, you really gotta pay attention to how you move. The next one, keep your rib cage neutral a little more, okay?
Okay.
And then I'm gonna push you a little more on this one, all right?
Okay.
So you keep the technique and I will assist in making sure the upper arm gets all the way back here.
Okay.
Yes.
So much harder when you're fighting that shoulder down to that extent.
The lat lights the fuck up.
Because I mean, I've thought about keeping my shoulder down, but I mean, like fighting it down that hard.
Fighting it towards this.
Oh my god.
Like my lat's hard right now.
Yeah,
like
right.
Fighting. But if I go like this.
Yeah, you lose it as soon as you do. Yeah.
And think about it, the negative is where that's where all the damage is.
Oh my gosh, yeah. Doing it with two plates.
And the funny thing is, like, this is an exact example of using weight, making it more difficult on the motion. It's very easy to get in the whole level of extending your arm and developing power to pull back. When you develop power, now you're bringing more muscle groups together to move a weight, which sometimes necessarily is not appropriate when you're trying to isolate an area that's not growing or not growing how fast as you want it to. If your particular person has a great back, train however you want. But if you're really trying to isolate something that's not growing, you need to rethink about how you're moving the weight and not just think about adding more weight, doing more reps, doing more sets. Relook at how you're doing it, because you can see, you can feel it more, right?
Oh, gosh, yeah. Yeah. I mean, back has been one of our, been basically our main focus this offseason. And we've made a lot of progress. But using these principles even more, the more you hone in on things, the better you get as a bodybuilder. You can always take it a step above. It's all about learning how to get that extra little bit that makes you that little bit better every year. Yeah, I mean, like I said, we've already discussed this. Mm. I do a high cable row typically as my first movement. It's very similar to this. And I lock that shoulder down, but to the extent that he has me fighting that shoulder down, it's like another level. Like, I'm gonna have to back off on the weight that I'm using at home just to allow that shoulder to fight down that hard. My lat's just completely on fire.
You didn't lose tension on the area at all, right?
Not at all.
Okay.
Not at all.
This is last, okay?
Yeah.
The second I go like this, now it's like trap, rhomboid, lap, teres minor. Now gotcha. I'm bringing the whole back into the motion. Mm. But genetically, if I'm built in a certain way where I'm trap dominant or upper back dominant, when I pull, I'm gonna be feeling it there and not here. Versus the opposite, if I'm lat dominant and I'm pulling like this, I might only feel it here and not much in my upper back. So like, depending on the person, has to move in a way to fit them, right? But I mean, this has its merit. Like, we have to do that, you know? Some exercise. Tension at all?
No. I mean, I felt it the whole way, dude. My lower lats, I love this routine.
The second you lose tension, stop. Stop. Yeah. That's technical failure.
Right. Yeah, that's something that a lot of people don't understand. Mechanical failure is where people will think they're gonna go to failure, but they start recruiting every other muscle aside from that muscle to go to failure. You need to take that muscle, the target muscle, to failure, not every other muscle around it. So that's what we're trying to do here, is just take my lat to absolute failure.
And a perfect example of that is if he started to fail and compensate, he'd be going like this, arching his back, contorting his body to try to get, you're already done, you're done. Now you're trying to bring other muscles to assist. It's not what we're trying to do. It's not what we're trying to do.
First exercise.
Well, this is normal. We know this is you.
Yeah, this is my issue. This is why I don't know if I could live in Texas, Chris. The sweat. It's like.
All right, guys, if our IFBB Pro can clean his machine up, so can you. Don't be that guy.
Put your weights up. Clean your machine if you sweat all over it. Don't be a douchebag. That?
Neutral spine, not a rounded spine.
Okay,
like that. Squeeze. Yep. Are you feeling it here?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yes. There we go.
Lumbar spine control.
Don't lift the chest up. Good connection here?
Yeah.
Okay. Strong connection or like, yeah?
I think once I grab some a little bit more weight, I think I'll pull more.
Okay.
I mean, it's pretty strong. Like, honestly, my lats are so pumped.
Okay.
I feel like I could feel anything right now.
Okay.
From that last movement, like they're just blown up.
The best thing with this to get the most is stop the weight and then go like this. Because then your upper, but I notice that if I go like this, I automatically, yeah.
Right.
But if I stop and I go like this, my lats are fucking on fire.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. He's like, your lats are a stabilizer of your spine. So when people are doing this, you're actually taking your lats out of the movement by lifting your chest up. You might feel them because the lats are fully contracted. Just because they're fully contracted doesn't mean you're working them. Just like I'm doing this, yeah, my chest, I can feel it. It's not under load. So people get that confused. You want to be a neutral spine, back straight. Not like this, not like this. Neutral. And then when you pull without moving your shoulder blades. Now your lats are forced to move the upper arm to the midline of the body. It's not glamorous, it's not exciting, but it works.
Great.
That's nice and straight. Not much movement here at all. Just here. Over, back,
Yeah, just wait till leg day tomorrow.
Oh.
I'm gonna be dripping sweat.
Yeah,
I already am, but I'll be wringing my shirt out after.
Oh my God.
Two. It.
Yeah, and you're heavier now than the last time, so you're definitely gonna be sweating.
Extend the arm, stop it. Now start it. Yep. Extend it, start it. Slow. And punch. Hold elbows. Flex. Yep. One. Push. One more. One. Push. Good.
Oh.
Do you feel more lat when I extend those elbows?
Yeah. It like forces them in a way that like they don't want to go. It's brutal.
That looked fun.
Dude, this is like crazy. He told me he was going to do this.
Yeah.
He told me he was going to make lightweight hurt really bad. And he was right.
But you believed him, but you didn't like fully believe him?
Yeah, I was like, I mean, we'll see. Well, okay. Yeah, this is really lightweight and it's hurting like hell.
Yeah. So like, when people look at lat pull down sometimes, they don't understand like why some feels different than others or how it's harder to connect with your lats than others. If you look at this, this is directly underneath the seat. This one over here is directly underneath the knee pad. This is gonna have a better feel to the lats than that is. This is gonna be easier to use even for somebody who's a beginner learning how to do a proper pull down.
Feeder sets are already hard.
Dude, how you move something makes a big difference. Oh my God.
Sure, bro. See, like I was doing these wrong for a while until you corrected me.
See, you can do these for teres minor major, right? So like, if you're trying to work, the whole back and upper, trying to do a pull down and work your entire back, you'd be more doing this. Shoulders come up, shoulders come down and in. Shoulders come up, shoulders come down and in. If you're trying to bring more emphasis to your lats, shoulders stay down, and you move this way. Shoulders stay down, and then pull.
Good, you go right in there.
You see people do this shit. That's what you don't want to do.
Pull hard. Go down. Pull hard. Yes.
Go. One more. Go. 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 Go.
exhausted.
My lap's are gonna be screwed up here.
Thank you.